Being a working mom ain't easy. It's like having two full-time jobs and one of them doesn't even pay. Here are my three secrets for juggling motherhood and work.
By the end of this video, you'll have four actionable steps to help you gain control of your home so that you can have more time to make money.
Three tips to improve your work-life balance.
So keep watching.
Hey mama, I'm Lauren Golden here with a new episode of Free Mama TV,
showing moms like you how to start and run a successful freelancing business from home.
Subscribe to my channel and hit that bell to be notified when I post a new episode of Free Mama TV right here each and every Tuesday. Number one, how to make the most out of your time with your kiddos. If your job has set hours and your kid has a bedtime, it doesn't do you any good to focus on what you don't have to work with. So instead, let's focus on what you do have to work with and turn that time together into a positive experience. This simple shift alone from lack to abundance will probably make a big difference in and of itself. Secret number two, how to put your housework on autopilot. It may shock you or totally gross you out to learn that I only clean my kitchen once a day. Yep, after breakfast, dishes go in the sink where they will sit until after dinner later that night. Why? Because my time is precious and I'm not a maid. This one simple shift in how I take care of my home has saved me time, energy, and most importantly, sanity. And secret number three, how to separate your work life and your home life. Now, there's a good chance that if you have a job where you're on a computer, then leaving the work behind can feel almost impossible. After all, technology makes it easy to stay connected 24/7. We're usually holding it in our hand, but maybe again, you're watching me in your hand right now. Technology in and of itself is not a bad thing, but not having any self-control is. If you're addicted to your work like I am, or maybe just addicted to being plugged in, which makes you accessible to your work, you have to establish some boundaries for yourself, or you'll never achieve the separation you crave in your life.
Okay, mama, today I'm letting you in on a little secret. Are you listening? Don't let anyone else, like your spouse or children, hear, okay? The way that I keep my house operating like clockwork while still pulling in a full-time income on part-time hours as a freelancer is this. I drop it. Yep, I drop it like it's hot. Okay, you may have already guessed that DROP is an acronym for helping you reduce what's on your to-do list, not the latest dance trend. Debatable. Let's take a look. D, delegate. R, remove. O, outsource. P, participate. Let's take a closer look. Delegate, as in let someone else in your home do it for once. Remove, if it's not serving you, it's gotta go. Remove this thing from your life and you're gonna feel lighter already. Now, this might actually be things like clutter around the house that you're taking time picking up or sorting through or having to navigate through just to find the things that you really need. This might also be activities. Maybe you're hosting an event at your house and it's stressing you out. Maybe it's the 3 hours of Netflix you're watching every evening. Whatever it is, if it's not serving you, it's not getting you closer to your goals, it's only adding to the stress and the overwhelm of running a home-based business, it might be time to remove it.
Outsource, my favorite.
About a year ago, my family decided to hire a cleaning company. I really struggled with this because I thought since I could do it, I should do it. Mama, it's been worth its weight in gold. Do it. Last but not least, participate. We're rallying the troops for this one again. Think about the chores you have around the house where you can do them together with your kids. Even my one-year-old is getting pretty good at identifying her clothes in the laundry pile and matching socks. A lot of the times when I see a mom struggling to work from home, grow her business, and not have everything go into disaster mode is because she's trying to do it all by herself. Hopefully, now that we're almost at the end of this video, you've realized you are not alone and you do not have to do it all by yourself anymore.
lazy. Millennials just want things handed to them. Millennials are entitled. No. Are you as tired of hearing this as I am? Here are three things I want everyone to know about our amazing generation. Over 60% of us feel personally responsible for making a difference in the world. We thrive on diversity and celebrate people from different cultures and races. And we give generously to charity with money, time, and ourselves. If you're a millennial mama like me, you're probably craving work-life balance in your life, but it's not because you're lazy. It's because you feel called to make an impact in your community. And for us moms, that starts inside our home. You don't want to have to choose between family and finances, and you don't have to. Here are three tips for improving your work-life balance. Tip number one, work smarter, not harder. Millennials crave flexibility. So whether you work in a corporate setting, remotely, own your own business, or stay home with your kids, if you feel like you're a slave to the metaphorical or very real man, you're less likely to feel happy in your situation. By working smarter and not harder, you'll gather extra minutes or even hours a day that can be used on other things that are important to you, like starting a side business, being with your kids, exercising or volunteering. Tip number two, take breaks so you can stay energized. If you're in a 9-to-5, use your vacation days. You earned them and you don't get a medal from your boss from letting them go to waste. Last but not least, tip number three, shrink your responsibilities. The biggest struggle I hear from moms without a doubt is there's never enough time. Now, I'm a left side of my brain kind of gal, which means I like numbers. So let me break this down for you. There are 24 hours in a day. Let's put sleep up there in the take breaks to energize category for a moment and say you're getting the recommended 7 hours a night. If you're bad at math, let me keep count for you. We're now working with 17 hours. That's all you have. That's all Beyonce has. That's all Mark Zuckerberg has. That's all I have. I've got two ways to protect your time. First, say no more often. If you're crystal clear on what you want most out of your life, say no to the things that don't align with it. Second, outsource. Mama, for goodness sake, stop trying to do all the things. Not one successful person I know does everything for themselves. Get your spouse to help out. Enlist your kiddos to do chores. Hire a maid or lawn company if you can afford it. Order your groceries online. Yes, you will need to relinquish some control, but if this type A mama can do it, so can you. Today, I'm going to walk you through the process of building out a work from home schedule that works for you so that you can end each day feeling accomplished instead of overwhelmed. And here's a question for you before we dive in. Have you ever bought a calendar either on the wall or a whiteboard or something and you started using it only to stop using it because it didn't really work for you and your family? Let me know if you're guilty down in the comments below. When you're creating a schedule, you have to start from scratch. Give yourself a clean slate and then fill in the things that are your absolute non-negotiables. This is different for everyone, but examples of some of the things that might be on your non-negotiables could include when you drive your kids to school or when they need to be logged into Zoom school for attendance, a family breakfast or dinner hour that everyone shows up for, your dedicated time for prayer or meditation or centering yourself, your son's weekly speech therapy appointment or your daughter's piano lesson or your standing appointment with your boss. See what I mean? Start by putting in the blocks that you know are going to be in place and that you're going to have to work around. You're here right now because you want to build a schedule that actually works for your own family. And that means you'll need to answer a few questions. How old are your kids, for example? And how hands-on do you have to be with them? If you're nursing newborn twins, for example, it's probably not realistic to plan for 3 hours of uninterrupted deep work from 8 to 11 a.m. But if your kids are teens and tweens who are logging into Zoom school each morning, that schedule might work perfectly. Next question, how much work do you need to fit into your week? Think about how many clients you're currently serving. What do you do for each one? And about how long does that take you? If you currently have one social media client and you're drafting and scheduling posts for about 2 hours a week, then you don't need to give yourself 15 hours of work time, right? On the flip side, if you're currently working with four clients and the work you do for each one takes about 4 hours a week, you want to be sure you're scheduling in enough work blocks to get everything done without making yourself crazy. And finally, what time do you absolutely know you can count on for doing your work? Like, when is someone else responsible for feeding and washing your small humans? Think about your other responsibilities. Dinner doesn't just magically appear on the table, at least not at my house, unfortunately. And sadly, I have never seen a real live laundry fairy. So I schedule in time to get those things done too. And I recommend that you do the same. Finally, it's not a bad idea to schedule in some of your downtime. I know that might sound a little bit weird, but it definitely helps me to know that I have blocks on my calendar where I don't have to do anything. So now that you know some of the things you need to think about when you build your schedule, let me go ahead and show you my own calendar setup. As you can see, I use different colors to represent different parts of my life. I use yellow for our personal family stuff. We're actually selling our house right now, so we have quite a bit of showings that have disrupted our schedule, but you can see that I block them in to make sure they're not interrupting any of my non-negotiables. I make my work time in purple, all of my meetings are in this light blue, and anytime I really have to be on and speak, I'm in these green boxes. By having it color coordinated and using a tool like Google Calendar, I'm able to quickly see at a glance what my work from home mom schedule is going to look like on a daily, weekly, and monthly basis. Now, personally, I use one calendar that reflects my entire life. So I have personal and business on here. And you can see I fit in all of my personal stuff in yellow as well, like going to the gym, visiting with my friends at mom's group, and making sure that I'm taking time for myself so that I continue to have energy to pour into my family and my business. If you struggle with time management, staying on track, or getting stuff done, you'll want to grab my productivity tool called the Daily Five. The Daily Five Productivity Planner is the exact tool I use to quit my job, start working from home, and spend more quality time with my kiddos. And it's been downloaded by tens of thousands of moms who are less stressed and less guilty. And now you can download it for free right now using the link below.
Also, if you want to join a community of mamas just like you, I have a Facebook group where thousands of mamas come together for support and action-taking tips and motivation.
If you liked this video, please let me know by liking it below, subscribe and share it with your fellow mamas, and comment below with hashtag #IAmAFreeMama if you're ready to set up a work from home schedule that actually works for you.
One more to go. Oh, what are we talking about? Juggle. I wish it like listened to my voice. Oh my gosh, is that my hair curled up around my neck? Okay, something like that'll work. That was like the longest thing ever. So I just don't read anymore for some reason. I'm starting to look down. Sorry, let me do that again. Oh.
We are out of practice with YouTube. Okay.
I don't want to make
building a work and then the kids have time and a bit we're struggling. Or you might find that if you take an hour to let your kids fill up, oh my gosh, have no fear. I just recurred.
Well, we're just gonna go for it. I have to actually do that now.